Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are listening to Jungle Entertainment. Here we give you sizzling hot gist of what is trending in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. If you are new in our midst, make sure you hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to get the latest updates on what is trending in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. You are dearly welcome to Jungle Entertainment. My name is Jungle. I am an entertainment enthusiast and a vlogger. Recently, Wizkid, the Afrobeat crooner, came up. He actually made a video saying, "I started my career with less than 5,000. With less than 5,000. This sounds like a motivational speaker. You know, motivational speakers will come and tell you they started their businesses with just 5 naira or with 0 naira. A motivational speaker can tell you can start your business with 0 naira and that you blow up, you become richer than Bill Gates. Bill Gates is not even the richest person on earth right now, or you become richer than Jeff Bezos. Come on, what is really happening? Well, Wizkid has said he started his music career with less than 5,000, but studio session is more than 5,000. Well, maybe when he started his career some years back, studio session was less than 5,000. That is what he's trying to tell us. And now 5,000 is small money. 5,000 is peanuts. You can't go to the studio to get a session for just 5k. I mean, it's almost impossible. Let's move on to boxing. Well, our brother Israel Adesanya, you know, that guy has been winning back to back. He has been winning fights back to back. He's like Floyd Mayweather. I mean, he's been winning fights back to back while he just lost his fight. Well, Israel Adesanya suffers first career defeat as Blachowicz beats him to retain heavyweight title. The Nigerian mixed martial artist Israel Adesanya has suffered his first career defeat after he was beaten by Jan Blachowicz of Poland by unanimous decision 49-46, 49-45, 49-45 in the early hours of Sunday, March 7, 2021 in Las Vegas. You tried, though you were beaten, and the defeat was something else. 49-46, 49-45, and 49-45. Well, you did well. You did well. You did well, our brother. Well, just watch this video.
And still, the undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, congratulations to you, our brother. You can't win all the time, but I mean, you've been doing very well in this game called boxing. Well, congratulations to you. We hope you win your next fight. You really tried. I mean, you really tried. It was a good fight. You really tried. You put in your best. But well, congratulations. I mean, in a game, there's always a winner and a loser. Well, it's time. Congratulations to you. You really did well. I watched that fight. It was superb. You did a good job. Well, let's move on from boxing, entertainment. Let us go to love. You know, love is actually what has been trending in Nigeria. Recently, APC youth leader marries two wives on the same day in Abuja. APC. That's actually funny. Two wives on the same day. And look at the wife. Well, he made a good choice. One is brown skin, the other one is light skin. We hope you won't cheat on them anywhere. I mean, it's not easy. Marrying two women and, you know, they're like sisters and friends. Just look at them. I mean, just look at this, you know, picture. They're behaving like sisters as if they've known each other for ages. I hope you guys will take care of this guy anywhere. Now, let us talk of this issue called Kayamata. In my last video, a businesswoman actually said, Kayamata is meant for married women, that only married women should be giving Kayamata to their husbands, that it makes their body appealing to their husbands so that the husbands will not look somewhere else. And you know, Kayamata is from the north, yeah, it is an Hausa word, actually meaning woman thing, yeah. Now, these two ladies are from the north and they are married to a man. So who will give the man Kayamata? Well, don't forget to drop your comment below. So drop your comment below. Let's analyze this Kayamata issue and this love issue in Nigeria. Not only in Nigeria, in the world at large. You know, recently we heard about Kim Kardashian, you know, planning to divorce Kanye West. Come on, man. What is happening to love? What is happening to love? These people were in love. They have been together. They've had kids. And all of a sudden, Kim said, no, I don't want you anymore. I want us to divorce. Well, let's move from love to something else. Four headers shot dead. Hundreds of cows missing in fresh Anambra attack. This is terrible. The Northerners invest a lot of money. They invest huge amount of money in this business called cattle rearing. I mean, they invest a lot. And now they are telling us that hundreds of cows are missing in fresh attack in Anambra State. And not only that, four herders were shot dead. And remember what was happening recently? The farmers in the north have refused to send their foodstuffs to the south. Stuffs like onion, tomato, garbage, and stuff to the south, because they're complaining that the southerners have been killing their brothers in stuff like this. I mean, come on, what is really happening? Well, what is your take? Don't forget to drop your comments below. Well, we have problems. We can't run away from problems. As long as people are in existence, there will always be problems. Well, recently, there's this girl, she's just 16 years old, Chidera, from Abia State. She scored 9 A's in WAEC. 9 A's in WAEC. I mean, she did fabulously well. And not only that, she was given scholarship and a trip to study in the United Kingdom. And guess what? She had been poisoned to death by her stepmother. She got 9 A's. She got a scholarship to study in the United Kingdom, and her stepmother said no. She poisoned her to death. This is terrible news. It's actually terrible. Really terrible. Let's move on to real love stories, you know. This actor, Samuel Ajibola, is actually known as Piff. You know, he's been acting in The Johnsons as Piff, as the clown of the family. So he recently he gave us a story of how he met his wife. According to him, he said, "She was my class captain in primary school and always wrote my name as a noisemaker, but today we are happily married. She brought out a wonderful man out of me, that is Piff." Wow, congratulations to you, Piff. I mean, you getting married to your class captain, that is sweet. That is love at first. Maybe she was actually in love with you right from when you guys were, in school. That is where the love started. And she wanted you to be a good guy. That was why she was writing your name in the list of noisemakers. Well, congratulations to you, Piff. Well, let us move on to football. I mean, we've been talking about Nigeria. Let's move outside the country, outside the shores of Nigeria and Africa as a whole. Where Cristiano Ronaldo, we all know Cristiano Ronaldo, he's been banned from changing the light bulbs at home. He's been banned from changing the light bulbs at home. You might ask why. Well, his girlfriend, Georgina Rodriguez, has revealed that she insists on changing the light bulbs in the house she lives in with Cristiano Ronaldo, so the Juventus star avoids the risk of injury. That is sweet love. She's ready to take the risk to injure herself, to sustain injury, but she doesn't want her lover, Cristiano Ronaldo, to sustain injury. That's why she banned him. She placed a ban on him, like, sweetheart, baby, or whatever he calls him. Please, stop changing the light bulbs. If there's any issue, there's any dead bulb, let me know. I will change the bulb, or leave it for me. I'll do that. Man, that is sweet love. Can that happen in Nigeria? I mean, come on, man. Can it really happen in this country called Nigeria? Well, drop your comments below. Let's move on to the United States of America. I mean, we've talked about football, we've talked about love. Jay-Z, we all know Jay-Z. He's a rap icon. Jay-Z sells majority stake in Tidal Music streaming service to Jack Dorsey Square. $297 million deal. Hands control to Twitter co-founder with, you know, Beyonce, Madonna, Rihanna, and other Tidal co-owners retaining stakes. That is huge. Anyway, that is huge. Well, Jay-Z, we know you have been a superb investor. I mean, you look at the market very well, you do your analysis very well before investing. For you to sell Tidal, that means you must have thought a lot about this. And I mean, Dorsey is huge. I mean, Twitter has been booming. I remember Jack Dorsey is the co-founder of Twitter, though he has the highest stake. I mean, come on, man. Jay-Z, congratulations to you. love hearing news like I love hearing good news like this, news of people investing money to make returns. Still on football, man, Obafemi Martins is the biggest Nigerian footballer with the most expensive cars. Thanks to football, man, this guy has been making it, man. Martins made massive money at Inter Milan and also in the Chinese Super League. You know, if anybody goes to China, you're just going there to make money. Those guys are paying huge, huge amount of money. They'll pay you well. Martins with 775 million naira worth of cars, top list of Nigerian stars with luxurious cars. Well, congratulations to you, Martins. You'll be doing well. Well, I wish I can play this football. I would have been making money like Martins. Come on, man. 775 million naira worth of cars. That is huge. Super huge, man. Super huge. Love story is always our issue. I mean, love. Broken love here and there. Broken love stories in Nigeria. Well, recently, FFK, Fanny Femi Kayode, came up and said his adulterous wife tried to kill him, their kids, and seduced his friends. According to FFK, he said, my ex-wife slept with different men and stabbed people while trying to kill me and our children. But we haven't seen anybody she killed. According to this statement, he said she stabbed people while trying to kill him. Is it that the people she stabbed, they didn't die? I mean, well, the former Minister of Aviation, Femi Fani Kayode, has refuted claim by his estranged wife, Precious Chukwuendu, that he physically abused her several times while she was pregnant and also drugged and left her hospitalized. Precious, who is demanding full custody of their four sons as well as 3.5 million naira monthly upkeep, made the allegations in an affidavit she deposed to supporting in an originating motion brought pursuant to Section 69 of the Child Rights Act 2003. What is really happening? You know, recently the wife came up and said when she was pregnant, this man was battering her, he was beating her. I mean, and now the man has said she tried to kill him. What is happening to love in Nigeria? Kayamata issue is there. Cross-dresser issues are there. Broken marriages, broken relationship. Oh, man. Divorce is terrible and it's been growing exponentially in Nigeria and especially in the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. Well, there's this royal butler. He posted recently. He said, gentlemen, please remember that it is not considered polite to borrow money from a lady. That's an etiquette. Can we really borrow money from ladies in this country? Well, have you borrowed money from a lady before? Maybe a girl, you're in love with her, and you're like, hello, baby, I need money. Like, how much did you say? I need like 100,000 or 1 million naira. She was like, okay, send me your account number. She credits your account. But according to this royal butler, he said it is not considered polite to borrow money from a lady. What do you think about that? What do you say about that? Don't forget to drop your comments below. Thank you very much for watching Jungle Entertainment. We hope you are dearly entertained. Don't forget to drop your comments below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to get the latest update on what is happening in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. Have a lovely day and take care of you.